-18x + 9y = 72. Right. So we're talking about equations written in standard form, equations of lines, where if we graph all of the x and y combinations that could possibly work in this equation, and there are an infinite number of them, we get a line. Okay. All standard form equations look like this. Something times x plus something times y equals a number. Real quickly, let me show you that that has to be linear. Remember that any linear equation will look like this. Okay. It can be written that way. So if I can get this to look like y equals a number times x plus a number, then we know that this must be a linear equation. So if I subtract 8x from both sides, now we have by equals negative ax plus c. It looks almost like this. Right? I have something times x plus something, a number times x plus a number. Almost got it. How are we going to finish it up?
Divide by b on both sides.
Exactly. So y equals, so divide by b. And when I divide two numbers that are added together, this number plus this number, divide each one of them by the same thing. So we get it to look like negative a over b. By the way, none of this has, you know, none of this needs to be done for number 8. Just showing you that this has to be linear. Because now it looks like a number times x plus a number. But the first part of this does, I think, does it? No, it doesn't say to solve from that. So it just says to graph it. Just to graph it. Since we know it's going to be a line when we graph it, since we know it's going to be a line, how many points do you must you find? You must find at least two. But two is the minimum you can find. We talked about a strategy for finding two points that are relatively hassle-free. Aiden? Right, so we get 2 points that way. We get a point with 0 for y and a point that has 0 for x. If we plug in 0 for x, what equation will that make?
Richard?
9y equals 72.
Got it. That's the equation we get. We divide by 9 on both sides. I have a good feeling about today. We put a 0 in for y, what equation do we get?
-18x
equals. No, -18x equals what?
72.
72. Okay, then x equals -4. So we have a point at 0, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's on the y-axis. That point is called a what?
Y-intercept.
The y-intercept. That's where the line is going to intercept the y-axis. And -4, 0. And we go. The x-intercept, very good. The x-intercept, that's where it intercepts the x-axis. And there we go. Good looking line. Remember a better looking line than that one. Okay, any questions about that?
You don't expect them to have these problems in it?
You bet.
I mean, this is textbook easy.
That's not a sport.
It's considered a sport.
It's chess. Wow. You're just moving things around.
Hey, that works.
You
don't
work out that kind of stuff.
All right. The best competitive professional video game players are the ones in best shape.
Seriously? Well, that's me, because I'm fit as.
You don't even like video games.
I do. I play Call of Duty.
Ready? Here we go. So we're going to graph this equation. We know it's going to be line, so we need to find 2 points. First point we'll find by doing what?
A 0 for x.
A 0 for x. That's going to give us -4y = -12 divided by -4. divide by 3, we get
-4.
Four, 0, 3, negative 4, 0.
You could plug in any numbers for 3 and negative 4. Like 2.3 billion trillion gazillion. Yeah.
You say you can plug in any number for x.
Yeah.
And, yeah, I mean, you're gonna figure out what the other guy is, what y is, but absolutely, yeah. I mean, if you look at the graph, there, what'd you say? What number?
2.4 billion gazillion.
Okay, negative 2.4 billion gazillion is somewhere way out there to the right,
mm-hmm.
right? It's a positive x number, right? And if I could go all the way out there, I would have to go off the screen, out into the parking lot, out past the parking lot, probably into space.
Really?
You could go
to
right
go 2.4 billion of these little guys, yeah. Probably into
home.
Space. Okay, but we would kind of go into space, not like rockets do, like stuff like we would just kind of go, just take off tangentially to the part of the Earth that we're on. Like it would look like this. We go so far to the right,
we'd
be out there somewhere, okay? But this graph just keeps going up and up and up and up, right? So we'd be out there at 2.4 billion gazillion, and there's a y value to go with that x value. Okay. Good. Any questions about 16?
That's easy
peasy. Anything that looks like this, this is called standard form.
But if it's backwards, then
0 for x, 0 for y. What's backwards?
If you had some kind of combobulation in there.
Like the line went down, you mean?
Yeah.
Then we go down into the Earth. But really, if it went out to 2.4 billion gazillion and this line went into the Earth, it would only go into the Earth for a while, come back out of the Earth, but they're there somewhere, right? And then we would see if 2.4 billion gazillion go down to the graph, there's a y value. So if that line went down, which is
happening. So, I mean, you're coming through the Earth, just a fraction.
This part of it does.
Yeah. And then going into space, even both sides. So the, and then eventually you'll run into. Yeah.
17, 2x plus y equals 8.
17.
I think that's right, 17.
Yeah.
17. Okay, same thing, 0 for x. That's going to be pretty easy. If I put in 0 for x, what will that say?
Y equals 8.
Y equals 8. Y equals 8. If I put in a 0 for y, then I'll get 2x. So that's 2x equals 8x. 4, 0, 0, 8, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There's our line.
I'm locking it up.
Asking, have any in your party? Can I have a name for that? Right. They're making $9.45 an hour.
There's like $7.07.
Right. No, they're pushing
what
for
kind
18
of a thing
hours.
Is this? When we read it and we say
per rate.
When we say per, we're talking about a rate, right? $9.45 per 1 hour. That's a rate. We have a different rate if we're acting as a server, getting people their food and their drinks, and they're still aware. $7.65 an hour. Okay, so you show up, and for a while you're working, maybe working as a server for a little bit, then you're working as a host, maybe you're working as a host at first, and then as a server, for a long time as a host, not very long as a server. Work as a server all day long, and don't work as a host at all. over here to the right, there's a picture of what looks like kind of a pay stub. The total amount that you earn is $160.65. Not per hour, just what we earned in that paycheck. So write an equation in standard form that models your earnings. This is the kind of equation that makes sense to write in standard form, right? Because it's sum of one kind of thing plus sum of another kind of thing
equals
a total.
Mm-hmm.
Right? What's the total?
$160.65.
$160.65. That's what we get when we add together. What two kinds of things are we adding together?
Post plus server.
Post income plus server income.
Mm-hmm.
All right. But I can't just say 945, right?
Right, you have to do X.
Times X, where X represents
the
hour.
The hours. The hours that you spend specifically working as a host. Yes?
How did you get 160?
It's just right here in this picture. It's like a little pay stub.
On the side
of the
well.
Side it says earnings for this pay period, 166.
Oh, well, I just went ahead and took the numbers times each other.
Those numbers times each other doesn't make any sense.
Yeah.
$765 is my rate I make as a server, right? And if I know the hours that I've worked as a server, I can multiply those together. So should I put 765x?
Why? Because
why not
it's
x?
A different.
Okay. It's not necessarily different. It could be the same, but it's most likely not the same.
Right.
Can
we do the exact same?
Now we want to graph it, so we're going to put a 0 in for x and a 0 in for y. When I put in a 0 for x, I really just have 765y equals 160.65, so I need to divide both sides by 765. 160.65 divided by, I already know this in previous class, what do you think about that? 765.
So we can just add
now what does this represent? What does this person done at their job at the restaurant?
He has $21.
0 hours as a host, but 21 hours as a server.
All the hours worked were as a server, none as a host. Okay, if we plug in zero for y, that means zero what?
Hours.
0 hours as
a server.
As a server, all of the hours are going to be spent hosting in this pay period.
14.
So 160.65 divided by the $9.45 per hour, 17. So we could have made all this money just by hosting 17 hours. We could have made all this money just by serving 21 hours, but we can also make it
custom.
As a custom. As a combination of those two things. And those are 2 points on a graph. No hours hosting. All 21 hours spent serving. So let's say that's 10, 20, 21. If that's 10 and that's 20, then 17 hours spent hosting is about there. And here are all the combinations in between. Should I really wrap this, do you think? In this?
Yes. Because it can go up. No.
What does that represent?
It keeps one on the other.
If I take this point right here, then how many hours have I spent at each job?
More than you could for the $160.
To get $160.65, I would have to work, more than 21 hours hosting and about how many hours, more than 21 hours serving, and how many hours hosting would I have to do? Negative. A negative amount. Can you work a negative amount of hours?
No, but you can skip your job.
Somehow I would have to.
You could be late.
I would have to work so much. I guess I could. If I skipped out, maybe they would take money away from me.
Mm-hmm.
But
skip it.
What I'm trying to show is negative time. It doesn't really make a lot of sense.
Or
try.
Oh.
Yeah?
Well, for that one, you could work so much, and if you worked overtime, then money taken off your
overtime means you work more than you're supposed to, well, not supposed to, more than you're allotted, and you actually get paid more per hour.
Yeah, but if they had, like, you know how sometimes they force you to take a break that
mm-hmm.
you're not paid for?
Mm-hmm.
It can be kind of like that, except not at the same time.
Well, I think at the very least what we're learning is they would have to take some money away from you because you've worked so many hours serving, you've earned more than that 160-165, they'd have to take some money off.
That's, well, that's what I was trying to say.
No, I mean, I'm agreeing with you. In some way, we'd have to imagine a scenario where they take money away because we've earned so much serving. We have to lose money to get back down to 165. Okay, it was 21. Is that it? Just wrap it. Yep, we're done. Okay. So, do you feel like you could wrap an equation like this?
I feel like this could be the homework review.
Ready for the homework review?
Yeah.
Alright, let's put it anyway.
Hey, Stuart, can we go over our homework when you're done?
Can you what?
Can we go over something on the homework?
We should have done that.
Just didn't that.
No, tonight's
one. Rewrite this in slope-intercept form, which means we're going to get it y by itself. Right? So how are we going to get y by itself? In?
Subtract 2x
and get that 2x out of there. -2y equals -2x plus 9. Ed? Aiden?
-3y
equals... -2 divided by -3 is +2/3 times x. 9 divided by -3 is -3. Here we go. Y equals 2/3 x minus 3.
I'm going to get this last question. Where are you doing this?
I didn't for
real.
I got that wrong.
Like
this?
Yeah.
That's okay. Like, when we get to the quest, I'm going to want it to look like this. Because only when it looks like this do you see the slope and the y-intercept.
Good question.
Okay.
Can we redo these homework ones?
They're worth so little, it's not worth
redoing. Well, I mean, it's when they add up and you keep getting horrible grades on. I mean, it kind of does.
Unless you're getting zero on all of them, really it's not worth your time.
Well, I mean, if you get a 5 on it, it's still a math. They're out of 5, Tyler.
They're out of 10.
All right, what's the question number 2? We're going to graph, which means, as we've done 3 times already today, we get 0 in for x. If we plug a 0 in for x, we get -6y equals 12. Divide by -6, y equals, that's 12 divided by -6, that's -2y. 0 is going to give us a
-3.
-3, 0. Zero, -2. More quizzes, homework reviews are now the time for you to show how much of an expert you are. Okay, it's one more opportunity to learn. And if you spot a mistake that you made on the homework review, one more time for you to be able to say, like, oh,
I said that.
I made that mistake a lot. So, on your notes, which you're definitely taking because you're such good students, you are saying to yourself, oh, don't make that mistake again.
I know what
watch
I'm
out
saying,
for that.
I mean,
watch the negative.
I had -2x + 9 at first, and then I'm like, oh,
okay, if you don't have your notes out, you should. As a review, a quick review. Graph these two here. Alright, for this first one, how can we find those 2 points we need? 0 for x. Yeah. The thing that I want you to see is that we can do this rather quickly as we get more practice at this. So, can I easily see what's going to happen when I put a 0 in for x? Can I see what y is going to be?
-3.
Very good. Very quick. Right? -3 is obviously what I get when I plug in 0 for x, because there's nothing there when I plug 0 for x. All right. Now the second point, let's see how quickly we can figure this out. We're going to do what now? Put in a 3 for x. We already put a 0 in for x. If we put in a 0 for y, then we've got some work ahead of us to try. And then we're not even sure it's going to come out nicely. But if we plug in a 3 for x, why would we do that?
Because that matched the thing of
the denominator. Right, the denominator would divide the 3 just like this. 3 would divide this 3, we'd be left with 1, 2 times 1 is 2, times 3, 1. So we went over to the 3, we wind up getting a negative 1. And there are 2 points we can grab on the line. Now I like that we think, I'm going to go over 3, I'm going to go to x is 3 because the denominator is 3, and I want those 3's to 1 divide the other, 1, 3 divide the other. Or I'm going to go over to 6 or 9 or 12 or negative 3, negative 6, negative 9, negative 12. Okay. I want to go over horizontally, I want to go in steps of 3. Yeah. Every time I move over 3, what happens?
You jump down.
You jump up.
2.
Up 2. If I go over another 3, where will I go from there?
Jump up
another 2.
Another 2. Over 3 and 2. Up to another 2, right? What do we call that?
Positive change.
Slope. Rate, slope, positive change.
Yes.
Okay, let's call it, since we're talking about the physical line, let's call it the slope. Okay. Just one. Another, just making that point again in a different way. Let's say that I can make 2 tables in 3 days, okay? And then every 3 days that go by, what happens?
Make another 2 tables.
And another 2 tables, right. So if I start out with negative 3 tables, which can be explained by I have 3 people wanting tables, but I don't have any to give them, right? So I have to make 3 before I'm kind of like at 0 tables. So I start out, I have 3 orders to fill, 3 days go by, and I've made 2 tables, so now I can give 2 people those tables, but I still owe a table
right
to a person. Mm-hmm. So I go over 3, and I go up another 2, and the 2 tables are made, and okay, now I can give 1 to a person, and now I have 1, and it's ready to go, ready to sell to somebody else.
Right.
And over another 3 days, and up another 2 tables, and so on and so on. Okay? That's the slope. So if we can recognize that y-intercept and that slope right away, we can graph these, no problem, right?
Right.
I have a y-intercept of what here? What's my y-intercept in this
5
equation? 5. And the slope is?
4/9. Negative 4/9.
Negative 4/9. So let's overuse this example. If 9 days go by, then
it'll go up by 4.
It'll go up.
Down.
We'll actually go down, right? We have a negative rate. We're losing things.
No.
Yes.
No. It would be positive 9/9. It would be 9/9.
Let's plug in a 9.
Oh, I didn't see the negative.
Okay. So there is a positive. Or sorry, there is a negative. So the 9's divide out, and we get negative 4 plus 5, and that's 1. Okay? If you're doing this, that's great. I think that's great. What will be helpful is if you can recognize that I can translate this to a slope directly onto the graph. Directly onto the graph. So I go to the right 9, down 4. Go to the left 9, go up 4. That's how that negative 4/9 slope works. As I go to the right 9 and go down 4, that's how that negative 4/9 slope works.
So you go right 9, down 4.
Right?
Yeah, so then you keep on going. So you go.
Go 9, 4, 9, 4, 9.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
But I only really need to go over 9 and down 4 once. I have another point, and 2 points is all I need for a line. So that's a y-intercept of 5, slope of negative 4/9. Now let's say that I tell you something about a line. We're going to go backwards. I'm going to tell you about the line. You're going to write the equation out for
it. I'm going
to tell you that it has a y-intercept of 5, slope, negative 4/9. Can you write that equation with that line?
Oh.
It is?
Y equals negative 4/9 plus 5.
4/9 plus 5.
Oh, x.
X. 4/9 x. Negative 4/9 x plus 5. Otherwise, it would just be whatever negative 4/9 plus 5 is.
It'd be 5 and 4 ninths.
What's that?
It'd be 5 and 4 ninths.
5 minus 4 ninths. So it would be 4 and 5. Well, in any case, if I just tell you what the y-intercept is in the slope, you've been keeping right up along as I've been explaining this slope-intercept form where plug in 0, you get this. Right? And we can follow this pattern here. Every 9 days that go by, I lose 4 tables. I don't know why I'm losing tables, but it's hard to come up with an example on the spot. If I tell you the slope, the y-intercept, just plug it in, right?
Right.
What if I tell you this? Harry, just show you a line. Let's see. I'll make it so that you can figure out where they are.
6, 7.
Let's say put another point out there.
Is that 7?
That's not on, you're not on 7.
No?
Oh, no.
Yes.
Close enough.
I'm supposed to be.
You're like, well, I don't
there.
Alright. But we can find what the y is, right?
Well, I want you to write this equation. As we've been talking about, that is what?
Y-intercept,
and this is what?
Slope.
The slope. Can anybody tell me either one of those two things? Yeah? Either?
The y-intercept is 3.
Y-intercept is 3, so what can I fill in here? What equals?
Oh, you can fill in the y.
You can fill in this y?
No, on the other side, the intercept. Yeah.
The y-intercept is 3, so I can put plus 3?
Yeah.
Okay?
And then you can put x.
You put x, and then I just didn't put the slope there. Can you figure out what the slope is?
7.
Is it 4 ninths?
It would be 7 and 4, yeah.
4,
yeah.
4,
4
7.
Yeah, 4, 7.
Okay, remember this is the horizontal because that's the thing that cancels with the x, and the x is horizontal, right?
Mm-hmm.
I'm
going
to go over it. 7 over 2 x is 7 to cancel with this 7, and
right.
The vertical change is 4.
Good.
7 is x plus 3, so that's really all I comes down to the kind of things we're going to practice on. I pretty much give you the slope and the y-intercept in some way or another. Maybe you'll have to figure out, calculate the slope. Maybe you have to look at the line to figure out the slope. Okay. But just a spoiler, there's a big, big hint. Every problem is going to, in some way, give you the slope and a y-intercept. You just kind of need to pull that information out of there. So that's what, 5 problems over there? No, that's a different class. This is,
or you can just do.
Did they go over that homework question, Kyle?
Yeah. Which question was it?
When it's meaning, write in the equation that the line passes through the point.
Yeah.
That what we just did up there?
Pretty much. I mean, there was 2 points, right? I could translate this to that by saying the point 0, 3 and the point 7, 7.
Yeah.
So it goes to those 2 points.
I mean, y 2 minus y 1.
That's what I would do. I would do 7 minus 3 over 7 minus 0. 4 over 7 is the slope. That's obviously the y-intercept. If I'm looking at the coordinates 0, comma 3, how do I know that's the y-intercept? Looking at the graph, what if I just get the coordinates 0, comma 3 with no picture, no graph? How do I know that's the y-intercept?
Because you already solved it out.
Why?
Because it's 0 for x.
0 for x. 0 for x, Aiden, right? 0 for x. So, like I said, in one way or another, you're going to be given y-intercept, whether by a picture or by being told here's the y-intercept or being given coordinates of a point that are 0, comma something. And then they'll give you the slope in some way. Maybe you have to calculate it. Maybe they just tell it to you. Maybe it's in a word problem. The word problem has some kind of a rate. Right? And the rate translates to the slope.